You'll never walk alone, it's so unique and special, not least to the red half of this city. And now one of the club's most famous fans has come here to the Elevator Recording Studios to record his own version of the song with his very own Cop Choir.
Well, I've been a Liverpool supporter for many years, and I think it's the goosebump moment when you're at Anfield and you hear the Cop and the entire stand singing this particular song from, you know, Jerry and the Pacemakers and various other people who've recorded from the movie, from the musical Carousel. And I understand that it was a father talking to his son going out into the world, and it's an incredible tune and a very complicated bit of songwriting. I was very impressed the first time I heard it. And I just thought it'd be a chance for me to put my little spin on it.
On Chris's new version of the record, due to be released at Christmas, he was helped by the resounding tones of the Cop. Members of Reclaim the Cop volunteered to give this version a truly authentic feel.
I went to see him in the Philharmonic about 3 or 4 months ago, and just by chance had a conversation with Chris's manager and the lad Steve Woody who's done today. And so I mentioned to him, listen, if you need any lads to do You'll Never Walk Alone, give us a shout and I'll sort some lads in the match out for you. And here we are, 20 of us singing in the studio with Chris de Burgh.
It's been real good fun, really enjoyed it. First time I've ever sang a football song in a recording studio and in front of a real live pop star as well.
Does it still mean as much every time you sing You Never Walk Alone?
You'll Never Walk Alone is not a song, it's an institution. It's with you since you were born, so always does.
You heard that You Never Walk Alone getting sung today and it was fantastic. It was really sung with passion like it always is.
It was interesting to hear Chris's version of the song being played back, which I think is really, really good. It's one of the best I've ever heard.
What's Chris been like with you all today?
Oh, he's fantastic. Yeah, really welcomed us, looked after us, and even bought us a beer. We were quite impressed.
Been fantastic. Good gang of lads from the match. Chris de Burgh's been spot on, dead funny, looked after as well. We've had a real good time doing it.
He's been great, yeah. No, he's really not your stereotypical pop star that you would expect. Just come across as a really down-to-earth fella. Proper Liverpool fan, which you also come across today. And as John also said, I think it's one of the best versions of You'll Never Walk Alone that I've heard.
It means so much to Liverpool Football Club, doesn't it, this song?
Absolutely. I did a show here in Liverpool with an orchestra and band not very long ago, as part of my British and European tour. And something happened that night which nobody is ever going to forget who were in the Philharmonic. It's during the show, we sang. I said I want to do something very special. It was just 2 weeks after the Hillsborough 20th anniversary. And I said, it doesn't matter if you're a blue or a red or whatever. This means an awful lot to the people of the city of Liverpool. And please join me. And everybody in the audience sprang to their feet. They waved, they hugged, they cried. And at the end of the song, they would not stop applauding. And they weren't applauding me or the orchestra. They were applauding the feeling, the emotion that that song inspires. In that way, it's as strong, and I guess for some people even stronger than a national anthem, mm-hmm. because it indicates a fighting spirit and the pain of losing, as well as the incredible joy of victory.
It's been so helpful to Liverpool on so many occasions, hasn't it? Because the words are so special.
Absolutely. Walk on, walk on. You'll never walk alone. And for me, it also brings back memories of Istanbul, where I was with my family. That magical night where we sang it at half-time, and we understand that the boys in the dressing room heard it, and the kind of movie moment, they gritted their teeth and said, let's go and do it for the fans, because we were convinced we'd, you know, lost. But it was a kind of thanks for bringing it this far kind of a moment. And but the song itself, the construction, the way it starts, my version is very, very close to the original, which is, I think, it's you pay homage, you don't try to do something different. And have these boys coming in from you know, the original Cop singers come and sing on it, it's a great privilege for me because I know they're going to give it a real belt.
Tell us about your love for Liverpool Football Club then. How did it all start?
Well, it's very hard to know. I talked to a guy today who lives here. He says he's a Portsmouth fan. I said, why? He said, because my dad was. So I think sometimes it works that way. For me, I was a student in Trinity College in Dublin, and Liverpool is Ireland's second city, as everybody knows. And I just loved the way this team was playing back in the 70s, you know, late 60s, 70s, sweeping everybody before him. And it wasn't just a question of supporting the winning team all the time. Like when my children came back early days and said, we want to support Man U, I said, why? So all our friends are, well, this is a very good reason not to support them. Choose your own team. And they've come to Liverpool. So for me, it was a natural progression. And then obviously going to Anfield, which is the theatre of dreams, and tasting the sour taste of defeat as well as the euphoria of victory is quite something.
Does it still mean as much then each time you go to Anfield or each time you watch Liverpool play when you're here, you'll never walk alone?
Every single time. And if it's on TV, I'm lucky at home, I got a large kind of home cinema thing with amazing speakers and a big, big screen. And I'm there and I'm standing and I'm doing that. And if the mood takes me, the tears will flow. And if Torres has done something incredible, I'm an embarrassment to my children. Come on, I'm leaping up and down, punching the air. And that also happens at the ground as well. No, I'm a total dyed-in-the-wool Liverpool fan. And I understand what it means to people whose working lives are possibly totally connected to a football club and their leisure time. It does become a sort of religion. And for me, being a part of this club and knowing a number of people, the players that I've met and the you know, people like Davy Moores and Marge Moores, very charming people, all those people, they bring a sense of family to this football club that I'm told doesn't really exist virtually anywhere else in the UK, in the Premier League or possibly the other divisions. But there is something remarkable about this city. I think historically the ability to endure bad times economically and historically as well, during the Blitz for example, during the 1800s where so many millions of people passed through Liverpool on the way to the New World, this has a very special feeling. You can see it in the architecture and of course in the football team.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of a storm, there's a golden sky and the sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on. Welcome.